In this problem, we're going to look at determining residence time distribution from making tracer measurements. The idea is that we inject something that we can detect its concentration. The outlet could be a dye, a radioactive tracer. We inject the slug to a feed stream for a continuous reactor, a steady state reactor, in this case a stirred tank. And we measure the concentration at the outlet as a function of time. And then what we want to do from these measurements is determine the residence time for the reactor and the residence time distribution. So here are the data for measurement function time every 120 seconds and then tracer concentration. So low concentration measured these times. And we get the average residence time by using this equation. So the average time is essentially just a weighted average. Integral time times the concentration, which is a function of time, over all times from 0 to infinity, divided by the integral of the concentration. What we're doing here is we're normalizing because our average residence time should not depend on which tracer we used and which concentration of tracer. As long as it's low concentration, it has the same properties and mixes with our feed, then it should not depend on which tracer we use. We can also get then the spread. In this case, we're looking at integrating the time minus the average time, and then this is squared, so it's always a positive value. Again, times the concentration is a function of time, and then normalized by the concentration is a function of time. This will give us sigma squared. The square root of that is the standard deviation. And we're going to do these measurements with a spreadsheet and Simpson's rule. And so I'll give you the answers. We determine the time is 371 seconds, then sigma squared, 3.23 times 10 to the fourth, second squared, and sigma, 180 seconds. Keep in mind, this is not accurate to three significant figures when we look at what the data looks like. So if we look at the plot of the data, we don't have measurements often enough time intervals to really get the kind of accuracy we might like of three significant figures, but gives us a good idea of what the average residence time is. And so to do the integration, as I mentioned, we use a spreadsheet, and let's look at how that works. So what we'll do, we'll divide it up into increments, and we'll first calculate this area. And with Simpson's rule, the way we're going to do that calculation, we're going to take the value at time equals zero plus four times the concentration at 120 seconds. So this notation means we measured 120 seconds and then the concentration at 240 seconds. So one time this value, four times this, one times this. We'll multiply by 120 seconds. That's our step size, if you like. And then we'll divide by 3, because we've actually got 6 concentrations here. Divide by 3, it's 2, so if you like, it's 240 times some average value. And to get that average value, we count the middle one the most. We'll then do the same thing for this next interval. This concentration, 4 times this, plus this, using the same type formula. We'll then add those areas up, in this case four areas, and we'll get the total area. So what I've shown here is a spreadsheet that's used to apply Simpson's rule. We've entered the data in two columns. We do this integration, as I mentioned, and again here's that plot, where we're getting the area of this first section. So 120 divided by 3, and then D4 is this concentration plus 4 times this concentration plus this concentration, D4 plus 4 times D5 plus D6. We get the area of the first section. The same idea now for the area of the second section and the third and the fourth. And then this just is a sum of all these values. Then to get the average residence time, we multiply C and D columns, times time times the concentration as a function of time. And we get the area again for these data using the same formula, Simpson's rule, 4 times for 4 sections, get the total. We take 2.23 times 10 to the 6 divided by 6,000, and we end up with the average time, 371 seconds. To get the standard deviation, this is time minus time average, and this is squared. In the actual calculations, it's squared times D5, where D5 is the concentration. Apply Simpson's rule one more time, same idea, four sections, get the total. This total divided by this area for the concentrations will give us sigma squared, and then the square root 180 seconds for sigma. And so we can use numerical data and a spreadsheet to calculate an average residence time and a distribution. And certainly if we had more data, we apply the exact same idea and get a more accurate value of the residence time distribution.